Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chancellor, welcome. One of the benefits to serving on the Appropriations Committee for more than 1 year is having a little bit of history. And for the last 3 or 4 years during these appropriations hearings, I've asked you and your two predecessors sort of the same question about what are you doing to try to attract and retain urban kids, particularly those urban kids who don't necessarily look like me? And sort of famously, in the perspective of people who sit and watch Pennsylvania House budget hearings, there was an announcement last year or 2 years ago, they all sort of blend together, about a $1.5 million initiative from one of your universities specifically to target Hispanic and Latino kids. The reward for that $1.5 million announcement or whatever the dollar figure was is that your total enrollment of new kids joining your system who are Latino has dropped from 1,130, which is pathetically low on your best year, to 985 kids in the entire Commonwealth of Pennsylvania who cite as their heritage and their lineage, according to your numbers here, yeah, as Latino or Hispanic in your entire system.
Yeah.
Whatever you're doing, it is woefully inadequate. Yeah. It is shameful, and it needs to improve. Now, our African-American kids, by your own numbers, you had 1,865 across the entire Commonwealth, and that includes one of your 14 universities being a historically black college.
So, a couple things. Let me take your first question, which had to do with what are we doing. So, obviously, reaching into schools, into community colleges, into communities, doing all the normal things, putting in place and strengthening the obvious pipelines, working deeply within communities, whether it's through churches or neighborhoods or whatever. But then I'm going to step back and I'm going to say, look, this is a national issue. I spent in my previous life, I administered a large scholarship program, a $1.8 billion scholarship program. It was the Gates Millennium Scholarship Program. And it was in service to African-Americans, Hispanics, Native Americans, and I knew I was going to screw this up, Asian Pacific Islanders. And in these communities, you're talking often about building college-going culture, which doesn't exist. Right. And I agree with you. It's a national problem. You could even argue it's a disgrace. Frankly, it's an economic problem because unless we do better by those students, we will not meet our workforce development needs either in this state or in this nation. So it has urgency whether you're interested from an equity point of view or from a workforce development point of view. But it's not like you could just turn a switch and create a college-going culture where one doesn't exist. Right. So it's a partnership between universities, between schools, between communities, and with the legislature and other constituencies. So I agree with you. This is a challenge. I frankly don't believe, and one of the reasons I came here, that our data are shameful. Our data are actually pretty good. If you look at the attainment gaps that we've registered, and we're registering the closure and attainment gaps that we've achieved with minority populations over the worst 10 years that are known in higher education, yeah, I would ask the question differently, which is, how can you guys actually continue to return those results in an era of such financial hardship? So I don't disagree with you that there's a great deal more to do on the equity front. There's a great deal more to do on the equity front. But we're talking about, major structural difficulties that the state and the nation are facing. And those difficulties are not uniquely or exclusively going to be handled by any university or higher education. So I would argue we're doing pretty well. There's a lot more that we can and should do.
985 kids that are Hispanic across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania chose your 14 universities.
I just
fundamentally disagree that that is somehow a positive indicator.
900 new students?
985 according to Appendix A6 of your own chart that you gave.
Correct. Those are freshmen.
That's correct.
Multiplied by 4 or 5.
Okay. Still not good enough.
I don't disagree.
I represent a school district of 17,000 kids. 90% of them are kids of color.
And how many are going to college?
A couple thousand. Yeah. And I have, as a member of the Appropriations Committee, as a third-term member of the legislature, one of 253 overall votes to fund your universities.
Yeah.
And I am not seeing any investment in at least my urban core, the urban core I represent, in terms of any kind of real outreach. And I've been asking, begging, pleading for this, for some kind of effort from your 14 universities for the last 3 years on this committee. Whatever your collective efforts are, they are not good enough in our urban core and our urban core of kids of color. And I'm thrilled to hear that you're looking at the entire system from a completely different perspective. I'm thrilled to, in fact, frankly, and I'm going to be perfectly candid, this is the first time I'm hearing anything from Pashy as a supporter of higher education. This is the first time I'm hearing from Pashy an overall desire to change the way you're doing things. I am going to beg and implore you, and I will say my future votes for appropriations are going to continue to be tied upon the fact that as part of your reforms, you're going to have to do a better job and build a real relationship with our communities of color, our at-risk kids, whether regardless of what urban core they're part of or what area of the Commonwealth they are, because what we are doing now is not working.
And you
thank you, Mr. Chairman.
May I respond? And you should expect no less from us. And just to point out that the goals that we were talking about before, the system and university level goals that we were talking about, they will be, the data and the goals themselves will be disaggregated, which means that you will be able to identify goals for individual populations.
And I do appreciate that. Thank you.